Okay, Facebook, Snapchat, Instagram, YouTube, I'm back. And this is Glam Beats. So now I finished my face on the first video. So this is the second part. Now I'm about to do my eyes and then I'm gonna do my eyebrows too at the end. So for my I'm gonna go in with Fenty primer. Eye primer, and I'm just gonna coat my eyes with it and let it get tacky just so I can see. I'm just gonna go in and let heaven go over my whole entire Okay, so that's it, and then I'm kind of patting it with this brush. Oh, fuck. Anyway, I could do this better. Just get some of this micro smooth powder and cover it. Okay. The primer should be in place. I don't want to show it because it's dirty as fuck, but this is Fenty eyeshadow primer. Girl, like, it's been in my little bag and it's been in there for months and I just don't ever really use that. I promise I don't even use it. Anyway, so I'm just going with this white base. It's NYX Can't Stop, Won't Stop Concealer, but it's in the lightest shade they have. This is pale shade 1. Basically, because it's Can't Stop, Won't Stop Concealer 1 in the shade pale, which is the lightest pale. Pale is the lightest shade that they have, but it's basically an off white. I'm gonna go over my lids with it. Use the noise because I don't know how to just have courtesy in the city. They see you doing something, they don't care about the background noise. Oh Lord, I can't wait till I be back in my own house. There won't be all this noise and it'll be way more professional and lights, camera, action. Anyway, that's another story for another day. Maybe I might do a story time or something one of these days. Anyway, so you can see I got it all over my eye, looking a fool. I guess I'm gonna go in with these brushes. I'm gonna pat it in with this is a concealer brush. I'm gonna just pat this in with it. Okay. So I'm just padding it in with the concealer brush because in the end result, I want it to look. Because my eyes, I have hooded eyes, as you can see, and I want it to be able to be visible. Let me put some of this underneath here. I really need to put some setting pad underneath my eye, but I'm not going to do all this though. So, as I stated before, I'm going to use the Jaclyn Hill palette. And the shades I'm going to be using are Pool Party, Jada. I think it's Fireworks I'm using because it's kind of like backwards than what it really is. Like she shouldn't have did this like this. She should have put it just exactly how it was on there so it makes sense to people when they're looking at it. But I'm just going to show you the shades I'm using. You can figure it out on your own. But I'm using it as the shimmer shade. And then I'm going to use all of these shades right here from... Basically, this whole row of shades except this shade and this orange shade. I'm not using these two, but I'm using this shade, this shade, this shade, this shade, this shade. Then I'm using these two at the bottom underneath the eye. So, let's get into it. Alright, so just wiping off the excess of that white on here. Cause I think I'm going to try to cut crease when I'm doing it. Shade, I might change up and on the end do like these darker shades or use these browns or something. I'm just gonna probably end up using these shades on the end. But let's get into it. So I know this morning I'm trying to do it a little bit better because the better brush I use, the better outcome looks. Y'all read mist in the background. Please excuse me. Trying to. Let's see. Okay, this to show you. So, with this Anastasia brush that come in the Anastasia kits, I'm gonna start going in with. Is it this shade? Yeah, I'm going with this shade first. Let me. I have to hold my little brush and palette while I'm doing it so I can kind of keep up with what I'm doing. So y'all can see, but I can keep up with what I'm doing. But I'm going to pat it in first. Look it up. Well, because they dry down so bad. I'm just have to go in with this M504 brush and I'm just going over that. Cause it dried down fast. All that Anastasia brush is stiff and it ain't gonna work, so. Just go in. Hey, the shade. And I want to say this morning when I did this, I did the whole lid with this shade, but I'm not going to do that this time. I'm just going to go in with this shade. Once again, I'm going in with this shade right here. And I'm just going on the outer crease of the, or the top of the crease or whatever you call it. Expert at doing shadows, so if it come out looking a mess a little bit or it ain't perfect looking, it's because I'm not that good at shadows. I'm good at foundation, making the skin look glam and making it look like skin. I'm not good at eyeshadows at all, so that's not my area. This is not my area of expertise. I just want to give, you know, even though this is a tutorial and I know people are going to be looking at this trying to copy out what I'm doing or whatever. I'm just doing this for a look because I like the way these colors and I like the way it's gonna look, or I think it's gonna look in pictures or whatever. Okay. Now I'm gonna try to go in and hopefully this work. Okay, so like I said, I used this shade on the first. So now I'm gonna go in with this lighter shade next to the yellow. And then I'm gonna pat that in with this flat, where with this brush from Anastasia, I'm just gonna pat it in because it's so hard and stiff that you can't really just, you know, work it in. If you put on concealer at first or whatever, if you don't use concealer, it's a little easier, but it doesn't show as good. I put this on, I just swiped it going across like this. And it just looked, because the brush so stiff, it ain't gonna work. And normally you go outward and then go in like that, but I'm just doing what works for me. So once again, I started with this shade, then this is the second shade. So now I'm about to go in with that middle shade right here to tie them both in together. Let's see, let me get this Morphe M504 again. And then now I'm kind of just gonna blend all three of them together. Crease. You know, just going back and forth with it till it's blended in. Till it look blended into me. And I'm just going back in with the first shade again just to make it pop. Before I even start going in and blending all of them together, I'm just gonna go back on the outside and work that in. Okay, now I'm gonna use all three of them and then I'm gonna work into the crease. Just back and forth, windshield wiper style. I'm just making sure it looks blended in. And then I'm gonna go back with the first shade. Just re-go back in wherever I see is diffused. Well, where it don't look tied together, I'm just gonna blend it back here. Turn this Pine Nemo off for sure. Okay, I'm just wiping off the excess. Now, I'm finna go in this yellow shade. If this brush don't work, then I'm gonna go back in with that 504. But I'm gonna try to, really, I might just need to go in with this one. If anything, I'm gonna try to go in with that other brush, but I'm gonna just go in on top of that shade. to it, to the brow bone a little bit, but just swooping across where I'm just really just trying to get that in here. Back in with the M54 and just leaned out the other color. Just make sure it ties in. Alright, after that, that's pretty much, I'm pretty much done with. For me, I don't go in trying to perfect my eyeshadow like that right now because I'm not that good at it and it's just my work in progress for it. Let's do a mascara on my eyelids. Anyway, so now I'm just use the base part, the flat part of that Anastasia brush, and then I'm gonna go in with this shade right here.
Hey, dude.
Hey. And use this.
Nisha, I picked Arbor $3 up and put it right down that right there by your closet on that stand thing.
Okay. And I'm just gonna go in with that shade and just go all over my lid. Just make sure it's blended out where it's like a little summery looking, but it ain't too, it's popping, but it ain't too much. Me back and forth. And like I said, I got hooded eyes, so I wanna see it when I put it on. Let me see. There's one spot right there. Patchy. Make sure that I'm doing it on this side. That's probably good for me going left to right with it instead of going how I need to go.
Okay.
Yeah, I'm going with the dark shade. And I'm just going back in with all our shades and going back over top of my eye. And I'm just going to go back in with this brush, diffuse it. I want it to stay like how it is. But basically, at first, this is the finished look. You can't see it read quite yet. But anyway. I'm just going to use the same brush I'm going to wipe it off. I'm just going to wipe it off on the back of my hand. Now, I'm going to go in with... what is this shade called? Pool Party. I'm just going to get it on that brush. And I'm going to use it in my inner tear duct. for time's sake and for the purpose of me. That's what it's giving, if you can see that a little bit. So with the excess on the bottom, I'm just gonna go and working underneath the bottom. To just get a smudge pencil, but I don't feel like messing up all these pencils and having to wash. Then with this same one, I'm just gonna go in with all those colors. Well, the three brown shades, these three, I'm just gonna go in. Okay, and it's pretty much the finished look as far as like the shadows. Now I'm about to go in and let have, I guess in the description I'll put down the shades I used again. And real quick, I'm just gonna do my brows and I'm gonna be done. So this is the Goop Proof brow pencil in shade 5. I'm just gonna slightly fix up my brows. Now I'm gonna just start from the middle of my brow bone and work it out. So with about 30, I should be finished with this video. Oh, my brow pencil broke. Hopefully I got let me just go and finish, because it don't take me that long to ever do my brows, like, really. Okay. So now, finna go in with the Hourglass brow pencil, and this one it's called Arch Brow Sculpting Pencil in Dark Brunette. Right in the description. Basically fill that in. It's pretty much how I do my brows, honestly. Sometimes I do them differently, sometimes I don't. Yeah. Kind of fix the front, this side. Then I just used the Brow Pro Contour or Brow Contour Pro Pencil, and I just go in with the highlight shade and highlight underneath the eye. Then I just use the definer part, and just that's what I go over the top of my brows with. Darker shade. Okay. Oh, I told you what this was. This the Brow Contour Pro by Benefit. I can tell you, it's in brown, black, deep. So the deeper shade is black, and then the lighter shade is brown, I believe. So. Anyway, I'm going to go in right here with the lighter shade. Just to make sure. And then last but not, I'm not even going to do that. I'm just going to go in with some Anastasia Clear Brow Gel real quick so it can stay in place just for the time being. With this side in place, it's this side that's acting a fool. With me, this one. I don't know for why, but this brow gel lasted me a long time. I think I done used this brow gel for like a year or two. But that's because I don't always put it on, but still, it lasted me a long time. Okay, this thing came into a brow tutorial, not supposed to be finished by now, the whole entire look. So, finish. So really, I'm just gonna go in with this brush that I use for my concealer. Brush out that. Most of the time, I don't even brush out the lining because I don't be caring. Just picture wise, I don't want to look crazy, so I'm just gonna do it. Anyway, I'm gonna do a little bit of the eyeliner. I'm gonna start with this side because this side I mess up on, so. Okay, and I just use Cause I'm Black Fenty eyeliner. Just cause I'm black. No, I'm just fine. But basically I'm not gonna go out on the outer edge with it because I always mess up on that part and I don't wanna mess up the eye look. So pretty much this is the finished eye look. I'm not gonna show it. Cause my brows are done. Oh, let me put these. I don't feel like putting no lashes on. I was gonna put them on, but I feel like doing all that. So, put on this Fenty gloss. Put on, this is Voxum's Big O lip balm. And it's like the world's top rated. Top rated. Lip balm like this, I always sold out. You get one, you lucky. Nick got a little bit of tint, like a slight tint, just like this Fenty gloss. Okay. And I'll show the finished look. And this is the finished look. Get into it. I was gonna do the bottom part and go outward with it, but I'm just gonna leave it how it is. That's the finished look. I'm gonna put on some mascara real quick and then talk to y'all later. Just a slight bit of mascara. In here watching a hood again. I really start from this. Oh, this one eyelash, it just will not stay in place. I'm gonna clip it. Anyway, the complete finished look with mascara, and that was Perversion Mascara by Urban Decay. Eyeshadow from the Jaclyn Hill palette. Brows by Benefit and Hourglass. Fenty Gloss and Boxum Big O lip balm, and everything else I'll place in the description. Thanks for watching again. My name is Glam Beats, and I just what beat this face. Bye. Thanks for watching.